Rick Franklin, the referee, our buddy Nick at Fight Odds, letting us know that Bec Hyatt, a slim favorite in this fight at minus 160. Mizuki Inoue at plus 130. Inoue wanting to become the, well, first, wants to win titles in shoot boxing, which is standing valetudo, like kickboxing plus throws and standing submissions, MMA, and kickboxing. So she's got a lot on her plate at just 18, and of course, a lot on her plate in this fight against Bec Hyatt.
Good jab. That's what I'm talking about.
Well, she's very technically proficient, despite her young years.
It's interesting to see how the size is going to play out.
Hyatt.
I like the fact that Beck's coming with these combos, but she got countered with the left hook. Hyatt's improved. You can see the improvement from the first time she was in the cage to now. She looks more composed. You see she's grown. She's growing. More confidence.
Yeah, she's picking her shots really wisely.
She's embraced all aspects of MMA. Left hook connects by Inoue. Jab by Hyatt. And man, Inoue again, just 18. Look at her footwork, Mo, and just her entire, she looks like a seasoned professional.
She reminds me of a Japanese Pali Maranaji.
Hey, my magic man.
Yeah. Good head movement, good jab.
Showtime Sports Card. Shameless plug. Bec Hyatt measuring up Inoue. Bit of a feeling out process here. A minute and a half gone in the opening round. Uppercut by Hyatt.
I like the level changes that Beck's doing right now to throw her off.
Nice 1-2 combination connects by Hyatt.
Inoue has some good head movement, good defense. Because the shots that aren't landing that clean. Mm-hmm. She's moving out the way just enough to avoid damage.
Ooh. The right hand varies fast by Inoue. Now in the clinch, knee up the middle. Looking for the Thai plum, looking for the trip takedown. Well defended here by Hyatt, but there's the knee strikes from Inoue. Now Hyatt just barrels her into the fence.
Smart tactic right there.
Yeah, when you have somebody like a little busy bee all around you getting their shots in, it's a good idea to just kind of pin him for a second.
Short right uppercut by Hyatt.
I'll tell you this, Hyatt has no quit in there whatsoever.
Midway point of the round, as Inoue turns the tables, now has Hyatt up against the fence, delivering a couple of knees and kicks.
Little baby kicks.
I have never seen that before.
It's really nice because you can probably generate a lot of power like a knee, but actually hit with the shin.
This battle being contested at close quarters. Wow, on the fence. Lots of striking from Inoue and Hyatt.
Nice uppercut.
Oh, nice uppercut. Was right. Uppercut by Hyatt. You can see why in her North American debut. A lot of people are very high on Inoue with those three slashing elbow strikes.
Great knees by Hyatt right there. Ooh.
Another knee by Hyatt.
Manzi Nakamoto right there.
Now has the Thai plum. Releases it. Single collar tie. Couple of short right uppercuts by Inoue.
Now these ladies are fighting. This is what you call a fight right here, isn't it? It's a fight.
Strawweight heaven tonight.
I think this might be my new favorite weight.
So who do you think won in that clinch exchange? I mean, it seems like they both landed.
Close in there, now at a distance.
Oh, nice one.
Hyatt. Another looping overhand right there by Bec Hyatt.
It was blocked
by. Blocked by Inoue. Very composed. That's Inoue. Double hold. The jab now goes to the body. Under a minute remaining in the round.
Looking for the takedown there. Now just fighting for inside control. Outside hook.
Looks like she's going for a trip.
And trip takedown secured by Inoue, but look at Hyatt wanting to escape.
Nice scramble.
Yeah.
Inoue looking for the arm bar from the bottom, but being stacked by Hyatt. Good job by the Australian fighter. Has her knee there, and Inoue, though, very persistent.
She's digging for that arm, and she's also looking, I think, to reverse it, but roll her, but Hyatt's doing a good job of muscling her way and finding little technical hip shifts to get out.
Final 10 seconds of the opening round. Hyatt in top position. Looking to deliver some ground and pound to lefts and elbows.
Wow.
What a round right there.
My goodness.
I'd hate to be a judge.
Let's take a look at some of these little kicks and knees that the Inoue was delivering. That can actually be very devastating. If you look, she's probably hitting the CP on the leg, actually, right above the knee there, and just really doing some tiring damage to those legs. You know, it may look like little baby kicks, but I think the way she's turning her hips over and she's landing them, that could actually have a very strong effect on later rounds. Now let's look at that armbar attempt and how Beck, you know, she shakes it out, gets top position, is able to land some very strong punches and elbow attempts there. Anyway, still grabbing on, moving around, staying very, very composed on the bottom.
Phoenix girl Shannon in attendance along with Jana and Natasha. Mizuki Inoue getting ready for the second round against Rowdy Bec Hyatt. Hyatt experienced a rapid weight gain, suffered from a lack of motivation as a teenager before she turned to MMA as a way to battle her issues back in 2010, and so far, so good.
She's coming hard and heavy this round.
She's in the pink, anyway in the camo, and they're in the clinch. Collar tie. Single collar tie by Hyatt. There's another up elbow there by Inoue, just using whatever distance Hyatt gives her to throw strikes.
The fight here is for inside control. Who can get that? Oh, very nice knees for both of them right there.
Great knees for both ladies.
Now, Hyatt has Inoue along the cage, putting all of her weight on her.
She should drop down for a double leg right there, or a single leg.
Yeah, it's a smart strategy to use her size on her on the cage right now and tire her down.
You see how Inoue squared up? Great time to drop down for a single leg right there.
Now, the way Beck is pushing, though, does she have the balance? I mean, she just fell to a knee a little bit. Does she have the balance to be able to drop there and stay level for a tight single?
Well, as long as the weight's pushed, as long as her opponent's pressed against the cage, she'll be all right.
Oh. Well, now it's anyway pressing Hyatt along the cage as they continue to grapple for position. Hooks the right leg, looks for the trip takedown, and again gets it. But Hyatt keeping her in control, controlling Inoue's posture.
She's got a right butterfly hook. I think she's trying to maybe loop her left leg either over the top or create a brace with it to get out.
Inoue with a short left elbow. Another elbow, some ground and pound here from the Japanese fighter. Missing with a lot of those punches, but has Hyatt on her back.
Good posture there, too.
Could pass guard here in the open half guard, just a wide base by Inoue. And there's a left hand that lands, a right hand that lands.
Oh, nice sharp little elbows right there.
Get the underhook, let's get this underhook.
Inoue became the first 53.5 kilo shootboxing Girls S Cup champion last August. And again, we mentioned shootboxing. It's a form of kickboxing, but includes the throws and standing submissions. Jessica Penny, who we will see later on, has competed in shootboxing in Japan.
S-Cup. Bukao won that. Annie Sauer is an S-Cup champion as well.
Famed kickboxer.
One of the greatest ever.
Anyway, looking to pass guard along the fence. Now north-south position. And there, delivering right hands to Hyatt's face.
Beck's doing a good job of not allowing herself to be flat until just now. She was actually, you know, rolling back and forth, trying to get up on an edge, trying to get on a side, on her ribs, trying to create space like that. But Inoue's doing a good job of kind of shutting that down, knowing when to strike and when to transition.
Good, Roddy. Minute 45 left in the second round. Inoue continues to control from top position, now inside control. delivering some knees and taking advantage of that position. Now, Rafa Bosbrun always said he preferred side control of the full mount because of the options, including those knee strikes.
For a second, it looked like Inoue was trying to set up a Kimura. Good pressure, by
remember, she is just 18 years old. 5-1 in her MMA career. One of the brightest prospects to come out of Japan, making her Invicta FC debut against Bec Hyatt, one of the most popular fighters on the roster. Hyatt gating back up to a vertical base. Well done. As Inoue looking to change levels. Now delivers short knee strikes to Hyatt's lead leg and now changes up. So Inoue really busy with her strikes at close quarters.
And that was a good change. She went from a cradle to a single leg. Actually high cross position, and then she went up to over and under. Now it looks like she's attempting that trip again.
45 seconds left of the round. Hyatt needs to reverse momentum here as she's been controlled by Inoue for the majority of the round, pummeling now along the fence. Now some distance created, and oh, a slashing elbow across the face and a 1-2 combination. And now unloading with the strikes is Inoue. Right uppercut by Hyatt to stop that flurry.
20 seconds,
good. Knee from Hyatt. There's another knee that glances off Inoue's body. They separate. Final 10 seconds of the round between strawweights Bec Hyatt and Mizuki Inoue. Now it's Hyatt coming forward. Another light uppercut. Inoue wants to clinch. Coming forward. Oh. And she has Hyatt on the back at the end of the round.
Let me say one quick thing. And I just picked this up in training at the boxing gym with Jeff, and I have a friend that works with me named Anthony Vasquez. Inoue's defense is very tight.
Very tight.
Not much is going through when Beck's throwing punches at her. Mm-hmm. And that's very impressive because you don't see that much in MMA. Or in boxing, period.
Especially with little gloves on.
Yeah, with little gloves.
It's a lot harder to defend.
Very impressive.
Since you were name dropping, you might as well complete the name, Jeff Mayweather.
Jeff Mayweather. Yeah, right. Jeff Mayweather.
Think about what you're capable of, okay? Relax. And let him go, yeah? Let him go again. If the clinch comes and take down, that's fine. Off the ground, you're okay. So standing up.
All right, seconds out. Here we go. Seconds out. Let's go. Let's go. Yep. Seconds out. Let's go.
Good game.
Mizuki Inoue says that she would like to be like Megumi Fuji. Well, she is well on her way to establishing herself as a force to be reckoned with, but against the gritty and varied game, Bec Hyatt, who has also shown a lot of improvement during her Invicta Fighting Championships tenure. Third and final round begins.
Bec is kind of, it looks like she's measuring out for that big overhead right. Oh, or an uppercut.
There's a nice uppercut. Right uppercut executed by Hyatt. Overhand right just misses. Inoue connects with a 1-2.
And one thing I do about Inoue, which I just picked up, because my problem was I like to load up and throw hard. She just throws quick and snappy.
Yes, very methodical and very good defense, as well as you mentioned, Mo, in her footwork. But Hyatt standing over her now, keeping her against that cage area, measuring her up. Inoue misses with that combination.
Not many tails. When she throws, you can't really see her loading up or doing the bow and arrow technique. Mm-hmm. She just throws, and I'm noticing that Hyatt's in the same thing.
Yeah, very tight defense, but there was a right hand that connects by Hyatt, and then she follows up with a couple of short right uppercuts.
Go low, and the next one high.
Nice, nice.
Left to the body.
Smart strategy.
She's mixing it up is what she's doing. Going high, level changes, putting pressure, playing cat and mouse. And that's, if you're playing cat the whole time, eventually you get Tom and Jerry. But you gotta play a little bit of cat and mouse to set up good traps.
90 seconds gone in the final round.
Still moving very well, but now she's kind of moving back. Oh, I say backwards, she moves forward. But you know what I mean, she's very fast. She's got good lateral motion, good fast stuff, but she's also a little bit more in the defense this round.
And Hyatt doing a better job of blocking those strikes. In this round, there's a high head kick.
And I wish Hyatt would have been fighting like this earlier in the fight. Because now she looks a lot different compared to the first two rounds.
Trying to establish the jab, gets caught with anyways jab and the right cross.
The jab after the jab takes so much skill to be able to time that on the way back.
These two have some skills. I'm gonna need to train with them or something.
Are you gonna make your strawweight debut?
Inoue trains at Kedetoto Hakushinka in Japan.
Wow, she timed an overhand, came up with a left hook. Nice uppercut.
Hyatt, and another right uppercut. And now in the tie plum, Inoue trying to deliver a strike of her own. The crowd calling for knees. Knee from Hyatt.
That was a sharp knee right there.
Very technical fight here between Bec Hyatt and the debuting Mizuki Inoue. That was a jab, slap jab from Inoue. Maybe paying tribute to Pancras. Minute 45 left in the fight.
It's kind of interesting to see if somebody goes for a takedown at this point.
Well, I think Hyatt, she can go for a takedown, just keep doing what she's doing. Because it's looking like she could possibly drop Inoue and even this fight up.
And she's kind of got a read on her head movement, her motion now. She's able to time things and land them more effectively.
Right as we speak, Inoue gets it.
Right.
I'm going to say it, as far as boxing, Inoue probably has some of the best boxing in MMA.
I think you're right.
Well, we said going in, I mean, it's not hype. She is one of the more technically skilled strikers in the sport, despite being just 18 years of age. But it's Hyatt getting the better of the striking in the third round. Under a minute left in the fight.
40 seconds, Ronnie, looks
well. Overhead right by Hyatt. Coming forward, right uppercut connects, another right uppercut followed by a left hook.
Hyatt has to fight with volume. She has to throw punches. She can't just throw two, she has to throw three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Keep on going and overwhelm Inoue. Because when she's throwing one and two at a time, she's getting picked up.
Super woman punch there by Hyatt, who backs Inoue into the cage. And now, knee. And there's Inoue turning the tables. Very competitive affair here in the strawweight division between Mizuki Inoue and Rowdy Bec Hyatt. Less than 10 seconds left in the fight. What kind of statement will be made here before heading to the judges? Knee from Hyatt.
Yes.
Good fight.
Wow.
You know, I thought Torres, Rose could have been fight of the night, but this right here is.
I think you're right. I think every 115 around this card is trying to say they're after Carla's belt.
Yeah.
The strawweight stir the drink.
Yeah. Let's look at some of the action. I mean, there are so many exchanges here. Those overhands and uppercuts from Bec Hyatt. Like, just landing just beautifully. But then, Inoue, able to use her motion, able to get that sneaky jab in there and those little left hooks and slaps over the overhand. More uppercuts from Hyatt. More overhands from Hyatt. There you go. And then Inoue, her motion, you know, making some of those strikes maybe not land as hard as they possibly could. But I don't, looking at this one, I think Hyatt took the third round.
But the
Inoue,
first two.
Yeah, Inoue definitely took the second.
Yep,
who knows?
Competitive fight, but man, smiling, showing her youthful exuberance. Hard to believe, just 18 years of age and already so technically proficient in the striking, and done nothing to take away from Bec Hyatt, who is always up for a challenge. And another great fight. And I know this is a broken record, but this is what Invicta Fighting Championships is all about. The judges have tabulated their scores. Joe Martinez has the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the scorecards, and all three judges have it scored the same, 29-28. For your winner by unanimous decision, from Nagoya, Japan, Mizuki Inoue!